Hey, what's up everybody? It's Dr. Michael Hyland here. Today's video, we're gonna be discussing Parkinson's disease and how it can cause constipation, how those are interrelated. Parkinson's disease in particular can cause constipation due to primarily the damage to the autonomic nervous system that can be caused by the disease process. What's the autonomic nervous system? So the autonomic nervous system is basically the part of our central nervous system that controls the functions of our body that we don't have to think about. So think about things like your breathing, your heart rate and rhythm, your blood pressure regulation, your digestion, things like that. Those are all automatic things that happen in our sleep. We don't have to think about them. Parkinson's disease directly results in that damage to the autonomic nervous system, and so there are many functions of the autonomic nervous system that are impaired or don't function properly due to Parkinson's directly. Constipation is a very, very common symptom in Parkinson's, and again, the reasons why we kind of discussed that connection between the autonomic nervous system, but what you need to know more specifically is that the autonomic nervous system, what it controls with the digestion and the gut, or one of the functions, is to control the function called peristalsis. That's where the muscles and the smooth muscle in the gut, the lining of the gut, kind of does this rhythmic contraction throughout. And basically what that does is it carries the stool along all throughout all the windings of the intestine, down to where the colon starts, and the colon goes up and down and around. So basically, it's helping to move everything along and keep it moving as it absorbs nutrients and so forth, and carries that waste out. So when that peristalsis is impaired, slowed down, the stool can become kind of stagnated and dried out and get stuck in there. And so that's the primary cause of it. Another cause is that a lot of folks don't have, or I was going to say before the talking about hydration, I was going to say hydration and fiber are the other two things. But the second thing is that some of the Parkinson's medications actually also ironically result in some slowed peristalsis. So there's a two-edged sword there. The third thing was lack of fiber in the diet. A lot of folks with Parkinson's disease, because of the diminished taste and smell that can come with the disease, that those senses can become dulled. So sweet things we tend to taste for quite a long time, that sense is not dulled compared to other tastes, more fine tastes. So folks may tend to crave sweets, and sweet foods, especially, you know, candies and pastries and things like that, they're really kind of empty carbs and they don't necessarily have fiber in them. And therefore that can be a problem of not having enough fiber in the diet itself. Fiber as a function in the gut, it helps to actually bulk the stools up because it absorbs water. And as it bulks the stools up, it helps them to kind of keep moving along and not get stuck. the fourth thing is hydration. Dehydration is a big problem in a lot of folks over 65, but especially it's a problem for people under 65. But dehydration can directly result in that because if you recall maybe from previous videos, we talked about the fact that with dehydration, your body is going to pull water into parts of the body that need the water the most. And one of the places it pulls water from or out of is the gut. And so we want to be hydrated properly so that the water stays in the gut where we need it. Of course, in the bloodstream too and everywhere else. So what do we do about it? So the number one thing is to increase the fiber in your diet. Honestly, a combination of fiber supplements as well as foods that are rich in fiber, such as vegetables and fruits and so forth. That again, we got to bulk up the fiber in the diet so that the water can be absorbed in the lumen of the intestine and be used to carry that stool out of the body where it needs to go. Number two, drink more water. Make sure that you're hydrated, and make sure that water can help make the stool keep moving and bulk up like it should. And number three, exercise. Physical exercise really helps to keep constipation improved. And the reason that is because by the act of getting up and down, for example, getting up and down from a chair, doing standing exercises where we're moving around and moving up and down, whatever the exercise might be, that those muscle contractions outside of the gut can actually help to stimulate the stool to move, as well as the fact that gravity, when we're standing and moving around, can help move things down the right direction. So those three things are the quick remedy, but also, of course, consult your physician if you need further help with constipation. There are over-the-counter and prescription medications that can help with that. But those other three are natural remedies that are something that should be done regardless. So keep that in mind. Be sure to like this video. Be sure to subscribe and hit the bell for notifications to receive notifications of more videos just like this, educating people on Parkinson's disease and other topics. And as I said at the beginning of the video, my name is Dr. Michael Hyland. I am a physical therapist, certified exercise expert for the aging adult, and I am a Parkinson's expert, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. As always, be empowered.